everyone. Welcome back to my channel. We have got another tomato taste test for you. We are getting through them, I think. There's still a ton to be tasted. I think we're gonna try to do some of the ones I'm super excited about. Jarson's, Cazula's, fun-shaped ones. A really, really bold one. Let's get started with that. So I'm gardening in zone 7. This has been a really rough year, Northeastern West Virginia. We got hit with drought. We got hit with like a really, really, really long heat wave. So my garden has not done the best this year, but I have still been getting a few tomatoes off of each of the plants. But I'm trying to do these taste tests really fast because a lot of the plants are dead now. And it's only the end of July, which is usually when I start getting my slicers. So I thought this year was going to be awesome, fantastic, because I got everything in the ground early. We didn't have any like really late frost this year, and the rain was doing really well in the beginning of May, watering everything in. My plants just took off and I was super excited how early they flowered, how early they fruited. And then wham, the first week of June, it was like near 100 and it never left and it never rained again.
I don't think you can say that.
It was a real kick in the I'm gonna beep that out. But like, I have been bummed, but I shouldn't complain. I'm still getting tomatoes to taste, so let's just get to it. Okay, the one that is really, really old, my friend Kina from Norway sent me these seeds. She always sends me some of the coolest stuff, her and Lauren. This one is Poma Adore Lutein. I don't remember the name. So sad. I'm excited about it. I know that this is what it is. It's from like the 1500s. It's a really, really old one. I'm going to put some information on it because clearly I can't remember anything about it, not even its name. But I had it mixed in with my lawn keepers. And so lawn keepers, you know, they stay, take them off the vine and you keep them, some of them even unripe. And you hang them up in your kitchen, garage, whatever, and they slowly ripen. Well, these were getting ripe on the vine like super quick. Like there are some long keepers. I'm gonna do a long keeper taste test, but I wanna see how long they'll keep. So I'm kind of waiting on that a little bit. but yeah, so this one, Poma Amore Lutein, gosh, I don't remember, but we're gonna taste it. Yeah. It's a like probably the oldest tomato I've ever grown. Yeah.
That's cool.
I was so excited because I wasn't sure. It was mixed in with my lawn keepers. Yeah, it's very juicy. And I thought that I just put up a short of this one. I believe this was the first lawn keeper short I put up. It's very seedy. I thought it was lawn keeper, but clearly it's not. I'm glad Kina reminded me. No, it's not lawn keeper. It's just super, super old. That's good flavor. That's yummy. Yeah. And it produces really well. And it was ripening really early. It was definitely,
it's fruity.
It's fruity, for
it's got
sure.
A little citrus in it, don't it?
I think so, yeah.
It's sweet. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of crunchy. Not bad crunchy,
yeah, the skin,
though.
The skin's a little bit on the crunchy side. Let's see how sweet it is, but yeah, it is super sweet. Yeah, 6.5.
Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah. So I was super excited to save, excited to save seeds for this one, because I imagine like who doesn't want a tomato from the 1500s? Talk about heirloom.
Yeah, that's good. I'll get this better.
That's an heirloom there.
There it is.
Okay, there's another couple of Cazulas that are just calling my name over there in the corner. Do you want to hand them to me?
Sure.
I want the two like little raindrop ones. Okay, so these, I have a few over there that they're not quite ripe, but this is them being very, very ripe. This is Cazula 139-4.
Oh.
And they're very interesting. They're different than any other shaped fruit like this. The inside of it looks dark. I'm gonna cut both of them and see what they look like. Okay. Yeah, that one's like dark.
That one good?
Yeah, it's good. So there are the insides of it. Is that focusing?
I think so.
Okay. So do you want a top and a bottom and a top and a bottom or? I like it. Super fruity. That tastes like.
Not a fan.
I like it.
It's okay.
It's fine.
It's a little long parched. The worst of it.
I like it a lot. It's got like a
it's kind of mushy.
Taste. Doesn't taste whole lot like the classic tomato flavor.
Oh no.
None.
Nowhere near.
Skin's not tough.
It's mushy. Like if I didn't have any teeth, I could eat that.
I didn't think it was terribly mushy, but it's not, of all the Cazoolas, I don't know. That's the first Cazoola cherry I think I've ever tasted.
First one I've ever seen.
What's that green and yellow one?
This is Cazoola 83.
And this is, okay, so we've got a couple of Cazoolas.
These are similar.
Yeah, that are similar. So why don't we taste test those? Give me the other
this
two.
This looks fake.
Yeah, yeah. So this is Cazoola 61, and I'm just so excited to try it. It's so interesting. Like, the top of it's really cool looking. I don't know, like, hexagonal? Is that the shape? Like, star-shaped?
Five of them.
It's like star-shaped on all of them. Here's another one that's a little bit wonky, hexagon. But let's taste this one here. There it is, sliced. Very interesting looking on the inside. The meat of it kind of looks a little mushy. I'm not gonna lie. Like as firm as the outside feels, like it feels firm.
Woo!
Woo, that's perfect.
That's piquant.
That skin is thick. Again, yeah.
That how you say it? Piquant? Boy, that's...
Oh, man, it's so pretty.
Piquant.
Yep, piquant.
Piquant.
It's which so means tarty.
Very tarty.
Tangy.
Very tangy.
Spicy.
Of all the Cazoolas, I don't like that one. It's so pretty. It's so cool looking. It's so pretty.
The skin is the worst.
The skin's tough. The meat is mushy.
So not only does it look fake, when you eat the skin, it's just like plastic wrapping.
Oh, man. Oh, poor Cazoola. Not getting it. Mm-mm.
Worst Cazoola ever.
That's pretty bad. Okay, the one that looks similar to it, we're going to do that one. This is Cazoola 83. And it's similar but darker, and it's definitely, like I told you, that one feels more firm. This one's definitely feeling squishier. It's again very pretty.
The skin looks a little.
Maybe weird. I can find what the crosses will be, and put the what the
yeah,
crosses of the Cazoolas
seems
are.
Better.
It almost looks like butterscotch stripes on the inside. I mean, the outside also looks like butterscotch stripes. Did I say which Cazoola that was?
That's Cazoola 83. I gotta get that bad taste out of my mouth.
Yeah, same. Okay. That's more like it.
That's better. That's sweet.
That is definitely more like it.
Okay.
Yeah. Skin's not thick. It's sweet. I've had better flavored.
Flavored sweet. It's a 5.2.
But it's not bad. It's pretty good tasting.
It's pretty good. Definitely way better than the one we just had.
Not very tart. It's got some tartness, but not super tart.
Not much, no. That one's not piquant.
Not piquant, no.
That one's sweet.
I was so high hopes for that. It was so pretty. Okay, next one I'm excited to try. This one I grew. This is Fuego Rosa. Oh, it's so pretty. It's very interesting looking, and it's very, very pretty. I don't think the camera does the prettiness justice. Here's another one I've got. The outside of it feels interesting, almost furry. I don't know how to describe it, like almost fake. So the skin might, I'm curious to see what it's like when we taste it. I grew Fuego Verde last year. So this is Fuego Rosa. This is actually, I feel like this one's comparable to the size that most of my Fuego Verdes were. But they didn't feel like this. They felt like a normal, like, tomato skin one does. So,
Oh, excuse me.
Looks dry on the inside. That's what the inside looks like. I wonder if it's going to taste. Here's your slice, dear, and I'll take this slice here.
All right.
Fuego Rosa. It's very pretty. It's really pretty. It's almost cherry-like. No?
I don't like, that's weird.
Got a little bit of like a...
That has a stinging on my tongue. Like, not tart or tangy. Almost like... Oh. Mm-mm. That's not good. That tastes like a chemical burn. You like that?
I'm not getting...
Let me give it another shot.
I'm not having the aversion to it that you are, that's for sure.
Oh, that's weird. I'm gonna try it.
And like, as far as like a chemical burn...
Yeah, you can taste it.
You can't tell me when I'm tasting full.
You can taste the chemical burn. I thought you were going to say that's not something you could taste.
I don't know. Maybe I... Do you know that you can? Have you?
I don't know. It just has like a...
Okay.
Uh-uh. That's not good. Okay, that is... Them flavonoids are not reacting good with my chemistry of my mouth.
I can't remember if Fuego Verde was very good either.
No, I don't like that.
All right, well,
sorry.
I think it actually tastes like a cherry. Like when you put a cherry in your mouth, that kind of tartness.
I can't taste it.
I can, I don't know. It's fruity.
Maybe I've eaten too many tomatoes.
I don't know. And I know you're probably all wondering, like, how is the productivity of these? I can't really tell you. Like, this has just been a bad year. I might be able to tell you at the end of the season which ones survived the heat really well and were the biggest producers with a heat wave like we had. But as far as, like, most of them are kind of, they're all in the same, just struggling and giving me what they can. But, man. Yeah, that one's not bad. I don't know why
I don't know what's up with that one. It did not react good to me.
Okay, let's do a couple.
We're going to have to take a break for a second. We're going to take a break. You have a seed on your chin.
Did I get it? Why can't I get it? It just keeps moving.
There's a lot of debate about where the tomato was domesticated. Mm-hmm. But I read Mexico. Mm-hmm. So... I wanted to say, Speaking of tomato seeds, mm-hmm. the Pueblo people thought that if you ingested the tomato seed, that you're gonna have to cut this out. The Pueblo people thought if you ingested tomato seeds, it gave you divination, which is sort of like telling the future.
Oh, like divine.
Mm-hmm. Hold on, I got some clip I can read.
Okay, like divine prophecies or something, huh?
It is said that the Aztecs of Mexico and the Pueblo peoples of southwestern USA not only consume tomatoes as part of their diet, but they also believe that consuming tomato seed would result in being able to understand the future and open their minds to otherworldly knowledge.
Whoa.
That's pretty nuts.
Yeah.
Just throw it out there.
Well, eat your tomatoes.
Not that one. We just ate, though, because that one.
Fuego Rosa is not going to bring you any divination, apparently, so says my husband.
Is fuego a Spanish word?
I think so. Rosa is like the red or pink. Rosa, red, pink. Verde was green. It was green. So, fuego. I don't know what fuego means.
Does it mean fire?
Maybe.
According to an Alexa Answers contributor, fuego is the word for fire in Spanish.
Booyah!
Wow, good job, dear.
And you should leave.
It just means rose,
rose,
like pink.
In Spanish, is rosa. Rosa,
pink.
Pink. Okay, so yeah, pink, green, fire.
Freaking
and it does.
So what a waste.
It does look
time.
Like fire. Okay.
Sorry.
I want to do the zebra.
This?
Yeah, give me those. They look so pretty. Okay,
I
grew
like we've
one.
We've done big zebra before.
No, we did. What was the one? Big yellow zebra last year. And. yeah, this one's just straight big zebra. Oh, so pretty. The camera will not be doing this one just, well, maybe sort of. Look how pretty that is. That's incredible. And then this is it with even more of the pink. Oh, and this one I can say is pretty productive. For as rough as the plant looks, it's doing pretty good.
I don't remember it.
I was a huge fan. It was super productive. Well, again, this one's pretty productive too. Oh.
Ooh, that's fun.
That's what the inside looks like. Gorgeous. But yeah, Big Yellow Zebra was one of my favorites last year. Production, plant health.
Looks like a brain.
This one's gorgeous. I need to save seeds for this one too. So I'm going to put this off on a plate because I think I brought some in just a minute ago. All right. I hope I like it. Mmm. Yeah. Lots of flavor. I think I like big yellow zebra more if I had to pick between the two, but I'd have to have them side by side, I think. But that's got, whew, it's very sweet. Lots of flavor. It's also, I think it's pretty tart too. It's got like all the things I like. Like it's just packs a punch.
It's a six.
I think all the zebras are like that.
It's good. I think
it's pretty good. What do you think, babe?
It's all. I think all the flavors are.
They go well together.
Well together. They're not overwhelming or overpowering each other. Mm-hmm. Where it's either tart or sweet. It's all pretty good consistency.
Let's do. I have two of the Martian series here, so we'll do that. So
that
the last
one?
No. The last one we tasted was Martian Monster, and we did not like it.
What the heck?
Oh, son of a gun.
Oh, what's that one? Better eat that.
Just hit the ground and bruised itself. That's okay. That's a seed saving.
Oh, we
already
had that.
It's the seed saving one. You know that sound when a tomato hits the ground? Poof. And you're like. So this one is Martian Snack. Oops. So it's these interesting little shaped, there's a bunch of them. I'll just hold them up here. I probably have a picture of them. But they're these interesting little fruits. They almost look like a pepper, an orange pepper, right? Doesn't that look like a little pepper? Like those snacking peppers. So I'm thinking this might probably be kind of hollow.
Nope.
Nope.
Really? It is not.
But that's what the inside looks like. I'm going to slice another one just in case. This is, ouch, my biggest one.
That's a heavy cup.
Oh, this one looks better. We're going to taste this one. The other one, the inside looked a little bit iffy.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but it just does. The meat kind of feels mushy to me. We'll see how the flavor is. Whoa! Very flavorful. Yeah, got a lot of flavor. I think it's very fruity, tart. What did you just do to that? Let me think.
Fruity and tart. Nice job on the description.
Yeah.
It is a little much.
Well, yeah, you didn't weren't able to cut through it. Maybe my knife needs a little sharpening.
It's not that tough, but just in a little bit.
Yeah, it's
pretty good.
It's pretty good for the Martians.
Yeah. Can I eat this?
I don't know, you didn't.
Okay.
Save seeds. This one is Martian Glance. And it's really pretty. It's got a little bit of antho to it, and it's got lots of different colors and striping. It's a cherry. So let's see what the inside looks like. There's the inside of Martian Glance. There were a couple of the Martian series that did not, the plants did not do anything for me. Like, they didn't grow, so I'm gonna have more Martians next year because I do intend to grow them all. Whoa.
That's different.
That's very different. What is happening there?
Can we get another one?
One more. Oh, I'll save that one for seeds. I gotta save seeds, babe.
I know, but we gotta, you know. Tangy. Then it's got something else going on.
I think it doesn't have any like classic tomato flavor.
Oh no. It's good though.
Yeah, it's good. It's much more of a fruity, very fruity.
As with most of those little ones, you get the skin always left.
Yeah.
But it's not bad. It's good.
It's pretty good.
I like that. That's kind of, are you going to get any more of those? Because I kind of like those.
I hope so. I will save seeds, and I will grow it again next year for you.
Oh, nice. Yeah, it's pretty good.
Let's do this one. It's super ripe, and it's one of my dwarves that I was super excited about. And the plant was only 1.5 feet to 2 feet tall, but just loaded with so many fruits. And I'm pretty sure something's been getting in there and eating them all, so it must be tasty. This one is Almondine Dwarf. So it was really pretty. It's been sitting on the table, ripening up. It's completely ripe, and it's really, I like the shape of it. And like I said, this dwarf is super productive. I think this will be our last one, I think. Do you think we've done 10?
I'm not sure, man.
You want that slice? That's a mixture of classic tomato with fruity.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
That's very good.
That might be my favorite, like, weird looking tulip shape one. I don't usually like those.
The like long elongated ones?
Yeah.
Well, this one's like not anything.
It's only 5.5, but it tastes sweet.
Yeah. But also tomato-y, like
yep.
Tomato flavor.
Yep.
And the meat to gel. Is good consistency. Like, yeah, like a lot of times you see these shaped ones and you think they're going to be dry. It's I don't know, like you think that they'd be for like sauce making, like but this one's very, very productive.
I like that one.
Yeah, I'm gonna eat that. I'm sorry, babe. Did you want it? You want another slice?
Well, there ain't no season. Well, there's like seven seasons.
There's barely
there.
A seed. You can eat it. Just eat it. I think that's going to be it for this taste test, guys.
Mm. I got
still that. Liking it?
That might be my favorite of this taste test.
Yeah. Pretty good. Well, this taste test isn't that long. Maybe we could do one more?
We can do whatever you want. I say we do this.
Okay. This is Shamrock.
Nice.
So this is a dwarf as well. It's not part of the Dwarf Tomato Project, but I don't think. I'm pretty sure. But yeah, I've got, this is the biggest root I've gotten on it. And then these two are also, I just picked these last week from Materville. So this is at Materville. I don't know if I have one here.
You know a lot about these tomatoes. I don't think I'd be able to remember all that.
Ooh-wee, so pretty on the inside. What, remember what?
Anything. I said, let's try that, and you knew what it was, and you knew it was a dwarf, and you knew it was...
Well, I just picked it, so...
I mean, we've done like 100 tomatoes.
Okay. Well, I mean, I know some of them. Oh, this smells like one I'm gonna like. Mmm. Yep.
Ooh.
That's my favorite of all of today. Gosh, I love them green ones. Mmm.
That's tangy.
Tangy. Good meat to gel ratio. It's a dwarf green. I'm super stoked about. Oh. Very flavorful. That's good. Yeah. What do you think, dear?
It's good, but...
That's a good tomato salad. Eating it fresh off the vine. What are you doing? Do you need another bite?
Just a little bit. Just like a little bit.
I'm going to be saving all the seeds for that one because I do want to grow that one next year. Yeah. That's definitely
very good.
Definitely got some acidity to it. That's for sure.
Very caustic.
Caustic?
Yeah.
It doesn't sound like a good word when you're describing a good flavored tomato. So you like it though, right?
That's pretty good. I like the yeah. I was going to say the skin, but the second one I had, it was okay. It's fine. It's fine.
That's fine. That is going to be it for this taste test. Of course, my favorite out of everything was the one we just tasted, Shamrock. That was delicious. I'm a little disappointed in the two Cazulas that we tasted, but by far the one that I liked better was this 83.
Yeah, 83. What number was
this
that?
This one was 61, I
yeah,
believe.
Don't
yeah, 61.
Like that.
Oh, it's gorgeous, but.
That's pretty good.
That, yes.
But I might
like
say that might be my favorite.
Almondine dwarf is your favorite. Well, that's a couple of really good dwarfs in this one.
Yeah, that's good, so, though, boy. That is awesome. Like, that is sour.
It's sour, it lingers.
It's
yeah.
still there, too.
I can still yeah. feel it. And as far as the Martians, not bad. Okay. What was this one? Oh, and Big Zebra. Big Zebra.
Yeah, it was okay.
Big Zebra's a win too. It's gorgeous. Yeah. It's productive. Oh my gosh. Would you just look at that? It is a beaut. But that's going to be it for this taste test, guys. And we will be back for, gosh, I'd say at least three more. Maybe four. Maybe five if I can get to the taste testing before they're not ripe anymore. Because there's only so many tomatoes we can taste in a day before we just get bored with it. Right, babe?
Yeah.
Maybe we'll come back this evening and do another one if you're still home. Yeah?
Maybe, yeah.
Okay.
We'll see.
Bye, y'all. Enjoy your day.